Hey, Google.
Set a timer for 15 minutes.
Some gas. I'm on my way back to the condo, and that's what this episode's going to focus on. We're going to take a look at a condo here that I spent a year in Bonn Sands. Coming up here on the left, it'll be like a darker brown type building. And we'll take a look at the condo, and we'll take a look at all the expenses, bills, and that kind of thing associated with general living, cost of living, living expenses. Now, just to give you one example of what I spent to live here for a year, and you can kind of see what that looks like. So let's just jump into it. I'm moving now. Probably the other day of the year, after that piece of work, I don't know. But finally, I've been here for a year. Thank you. we'll go over what it costs to live there for a year. But people are curious about that. It's a place to live. If you are trying to get a cost of living, property manager or something. So he is the same management company, but over here, it's all my shop. These bags are the way to go. Cost about 80 to 100 baht. There's a couple different sizes. But, they're made up to be kind of burlap, they're water resistant, they're very tough, very strong, you get packed and stuff. So, I bought about five of those. Plus, I got two big ones. Two little bits and bobs. And that's it. So, I go upstairs and I'll take a look. I was in the second floor. And although I rode the elevator here, I never used it. That's probably only my second time in the elevator. But this is the threshold of the unit just coming in from the hallway. There's a nice little kitchen on the other end. There are a couple of burner stoves. The amount of cabinets was over there. Nice big fridge, right? All this furniture that you see in the game of the unit is also on the front table. Everything is at the desk. That's where I have to be. All my windows. So all that remains on the future. Washer, a decent washer and a shower sink, a typical three-piece washer. And everything was in a good state of repair here, although this unit was probably about 10 years old, I would imagine. It's starting to show some age in certain parts, but it was very comfortable. And I believe this was about 37, 14 stories, or 37. Bedroom even came with these bed clothes or sheets, which I'd never used. I put away and I just threw them back on the bed here for the last day. There's the other kind of closet, wardrobe, it's some storage. There's also storage on the bed and a window in there. You know, there's not much of a view out here. I'll show you the balcony. The little balcony, that was another thing I didn't care for, but the kind of face north, which I although there was no view, it was quiet, and it was sunny. And it's basically what you see is what you get. TV came with all these plants, the microwave, air conditioners, all that stuff. So this is just how I found it. This is just how I'm leaving it. I just moved everything downstairs I'm going to show you. And there it is. So we'll get into the expenses and how much this all costs. But first, just a word on some page. I'll go over some things that I think are questions. So for one, why was I here for a year if it wasn't a valuable place? In Bang San, where I live, you can't get shorter than a year. I tried and tried. Nobody would lease a 3-month lease, a 6-month lease. Now in a place like Padia, or Pyongyang, you can absolutely get that. In fact, I had a 3-month lease on a condo in Pyongyang. So the place you decide on may vary there, so you may be forced into a 1-year lease like I was here, which I didn't mind. It was very lovable, and during the 4-year, to look around and see where I'm really going to be. However, if you want a shorter lease, that would be recommended. Maybe 3 months, it would be enough. I tried to get it 3 months, but I couldn't. When you rent a condo, I went through a realtor. And you will kind of do business with the realtor as a go-between between the owner and yourself as the tenant. They'll present you with a lease, just very similar to any kind of apartment rental in the West. To move in, they will want a deposit, like a security deposit. They call it insurance. It's generally a 10-year fixed amount. There is 1 month or 2 months rent. Now, if you're more expensive unit, you do it by 1 month. How is that cheaper than making the other 2 months? So I have come up with actually 3 months rent to move in. And that's what you would have, no matter what, you would have your deposit or insurance money and your first month's rent. That's all due when you sign the deposit. So then your first month is covered. You want to rent the place, you get the deposit money. My lease says, so that's kind of just the nexus of the events, commonplace problems. Your bills, when you go over the bills, what they are, what they look like. Your water bill, generally you pay at the condo, electric bill, cable, internet, anything else you have, you can pay at like the Lotus or satellite, or AC, or something like that. Or you can go directly to the office. You can go to the, I had AIS, internet, fiber internet, very good internet. I could go to the AIS store tomorrow, and go to the provincial electric authority in the mall, and pay my bill there, and there's no fee. You charge a little fee in places like the local service, you can do that in the township. Sometimes you're in the US, worth the 10 bucks, you just pay it somewhere else. So, I think that gets everybody on the same page. Let's take a look at the bills and expenses. See what all this costs. So start off with water. And this was dated, it was almost the same every month. It would either be 120 or 80 or 1 month ago, it's 160. It's 45 water systems. I can't control the exact all bills need to have came up to 15.5. So that's what the water cost is. This is where the electric bill is, at least an electric bill, I'm sure for you. And they're different from my old landlord, much they were generally similar, around 500 to 600 baht. There was one month that was 900 baht, or 900 baht, or 500 baht. But you can go to just to get an average, there you go, 685 was the monthly average. That 1 month kind of pulled it up. Now, the internet is not really an average. It's the same every month. It's not like how much internet you use or it's 635 a month. Actually, it's less than that. It's 500 a month, but with tax, 640 a month. So it is what it is. Now, I kind of cell phone every month with a data plan. So once you have your SIM card, it's not like a monthly contract or anything like that. I just top up what they call top up, and I get, these are some plans, 7 day plans. There's a 7 day plan for 150, 30 day plan for 350, and that's the one that I get. 30 days for 350 bucks. So that's the same every month as well. I just top it up. Yeah. So let's add all that up. 6,500 baht for the year. 6,500. And then we have an average of 608 baht, which was our average electric cost for a month. And 150 baht for our average. And then 350 baht for our cell phone there, which is 8,213.5. We divide that by today's US dollar exchange rate, roughly 31.5, or 260-ish dollars. That's US. So, that's a pretty important one. The electric, if I were to buy a cell phone, it's going to include that. You would just be buying a cell phone. So, I hope that I'm going to scroll over 260 US dollars. Roughly 200 installed and about 400 units. You guys can figure it out from there, but that's okay. even this will be different, but I can show you exactly, because I have the bills, I know how much the rent was, I can show you exactly what my general cost of living was. I don't guess what I was spending a month on food and some of the other stuff. Probably somewhere around $7,500 for food. I spend somewhere around 1,000-ish a month, US dollar-wise. So you can see with the apartment, all the builders is about 45% of that right there. 25% of food, and the rest of the insurance. So that's kind of up to the individual. Show this apartment as well as the reason I'm going to get some.